Good morning, students. Today let us learn refraction by a lens. Let us consider a convex lens of refractive index n2, which is kept in a medium of refractive index n1, where n2 greater than n1. Let us consider a point object O on the principal axis. The center of the lens is the optical center C. A ray of light from the object gets incident on the surface, on the first surface of the lens, at A. OA is the incident ray. As the ray passes from rarer to denser medium, the ray bends towards the normal and gets incident on the second surface. The refracted ray AB passes from a denser medium to a rarer medium, so it bends away from the normal and meets the axis at I. So I is the image formed by the lens. Let us consider the refraction by the first surface. The first surface is a part of a sphere with a center at C1. The radius of the first surface is R1. The incident ray OA undergoes refraction. As it passes from rarer to denser, it bends towards the normal. And if there is no refraction at the second surface, the image would be formed at I1. As the light passes from rarer to denser medium, we can write the relation between object distance and image distance. N2 by V minus N1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 by R. Here R1 is the radius of curvature, so R1. And the image distance can be denoted as V1. So the image distance can be written as V1. So this is equation number 1. Let us consider the refraction at the second surface. For the second surface, AB is the incident ray. The ray passes from denser to rarer, so the ray bends away from the normal. The second surface, the center at C2 and the radius is R2. Since the incident rays are converging, the object for the second surface is a virtual object, or the image I1 of the first surface acts as the virtual object for the second surface, and the image of the second surface is I. So let us write the relation for the second surface. As the ray passes from denser to rarer medium, the relation can be written as N1 by object distance, N1 by image distance V minus N2 by object distance V1 is equal to N1 minus N2 by radius of curvature R2. Let it be equation 2. Let us add the equations 1 and 2. 1 plus 2. N2 by V1 gets cancelled. So left hand side becomes N1 by V minus N1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 can be taken as common. Then 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Here N1 is common. So we can write N1 into 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 by N1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. We know that for a lens, 1 by V minus 1 by U is 1 by F. So 1 by F is equal to N2 by N1 minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. This is a relation connecting focal length and radius of curvature. This formula is known as lens maker's formula. As this formula is used to construct a lens of a desired focal length. So we can say focal length of a lens depends on refractive index of the lens, refractive index of the surrounding medium, and the radii curvature of both the surfaces. Thank you.